All right, everybody. Paul Wyrostek, Master Teacher, Channeler of Healing. I'm going to give you guys an energy update. This is an energy update that I want everybody to see. So if you're on TikTok and you see this, I have a YouTube channel called Ascending Spirituality. Check it out because I do different content on there. This particular energy update will be on Ascending Spirituality. Like, subscribe, hit the thumbs up so we can get this out there to everybody. Your life's just beginning. Okay, it may feel really difficult right now, but your life is just beginning. We have a lot of stuff going on. Now, I don't base my energy updates on astrology. I know astrology, but it's really interesting to see how the astrology complements what I'm giving as energy updates, okay? So what I go by is my knowing. My day after day through meditations and my one-on-one phone sessions with people, I pick up on what's going on and I have an awesome view, not just by what I'm picking up on, but when I have these one-on-one sessions with people and it's so interesting through the years and years of how people are going through the same thing, like we're fish in this massive fishbowl vibing off each other. The collective is what we're vibing off of, and the collective is going to be a bumpy ride, okay? The shit needs to surface in order to come into the light. When it comes into the light, there's awareness. That awareness could be shocking to people, so then the awareness is going to have to integrate. Once that awareness is integrated, this is where true change can truly happen. But you focus on you. Don't use the what's going on in the collective as a scapegoat for you not to be able to grow and ascend on your own path, okay? So when I was thinking about what to say for this video, the perfect analogy came up. And it's for those of us that have been healing for freaking decades, you're not done. Sorry. You know, go back to my first Ascending Spirituality YouTube videos. 7 years ago or so, I said all this stuff, right? Layers. You'll be healing the rest of your life. That does not mean that you can experience, that you cannot experience bliss. You can. We're multi-dimensional quantum friggin' beings, okay? We're getting to the trunks, the deep, deep layers, that all the stuff you've been working on has been crabgrass pulling to get to this point where you are now. This is the deep shit, okay? But this is awesome. This is friggin' exciting. This is a time, even though you're going through this stuff, this is the time to set out those new beginnings, okay? To put your intents out there to the universe of what you're going to do and to start doing it. This is the deep, deep, deep healing stuff. So what this means is when, this is what I thought of, when we are facing things in the physical world. So say there's addictions, right? We all have some sort of addictions, whether it's overthinking, overeating, smoking weed, drinking alcohol, taking opiates, whatever it is, right? There's a lot of addictions out there. You're coming face to face with these physical things. Six planets retrograde, okay, through September and I think into October. So this is going to be deep clearing of the closets. So you're going to have to face something, and that facing something is going to mean this addiction, whatever that is for you. Some people are addicted to fear, right? Some people are addicted to social media, or addicted to, right? Think about it. What are you addicted to? So you're going to have to face these addictions. Now, what happens is when you start to pull back the throttle on these addictions, what it's going to do, it's going to pull like crabgrass all the deep shit from your childhood. The origins of where the addiction came from. Oh, yeah. Okay. Understand this is methods of phoenix rising out of the ashes, and then that phoenix rising out of the ashes, and then that phoenix rising out of the ashes. You're a beautiful, magnificent being of love that radiates light, that is a work in progress. So be loving to yourself. Be gentle to yourself, with yourself. Okay? If you're going down a dark, bumpy road, no problem. You can handle everything that you're experiencing right now. And as you're going over these bumps, it's shaking the bullshit off of you. So this is about releasing anything and everything that does not serve you. Okay? Blocks, cords, attachments, blame, shame, guilt. And one of my favorites to this day, ready? Thoughts, feelings, and emotions that do not belong to you. Okay? So here's a funny analogy, right? When I was thinking about this. If you guys remember the movie Poltergeist, if not, I'll elaborate. The daughter's like in the light and there's all sorts of shit going on in there, and he's got a rope and he's ready to pull it. And the little lady there that's doing the house purifications is like, "Don't pull on the fucking rope." Right? "Don't pull the rope till I tell you." And he's like, his daughter's in there, right? So he's all emotionally charged and he's like, "Fuck this, I'm pulling on the rope." And he pulls it and pulls it, and all of a sudden, bah, this fucking dragon evil skeleton thing comes out of the freaking closet, right? And is like ready to eat this guy's face off. And he's like, "Brah, don't pull on the fucking string," she said. "Don't pull on the rope." Right? So what this means is be gentle with yourself. Don't go all in. You're working on the surface here. So if you try going too deep, right? If you're going and you're doing all these different healings and you're going through all these modalities and you're like, "I'm on a fast track to healing and I'm going to heal this past life and this one and all this stuff." What if it wasn't, what if it's not of your highest of good to pull those ropes yet? Okay? What it can do is it can pull up the trauma and the emotional connections to the origins of where it originally started, which is your childhood. So there's a lot of inner child, inner work that's happening. So you need to be gentle and loving with yourself, with that child. The inner child is not some little kid lost somewhere in the ethers. That inner child's in you. Okay? So be gentle with yourself, be loving with yourself, just don't overthink, just deal with what comes up. One day at a time, one moment at a time, one second at a time. Okay? But this is a time I've called way back in the day the adult toddler program, right? We're learning how to walk again, right? So you're going to be experiencing these things that are encouraging you. Okay, to take your first steps without the blocks, cords, and the attachments and all that shit from the past, right? So we're multidimensional quantum beings, so we can do multiple things at the same time. So this is about being excited because this stuff has to go. It has to go. Okay? You can't transform. You can't transition from the third dimension to the fifth dimension. You can't carry this shit with you. You cannot. This is a complete transformation, baby. Yeah. All right. So this is super friggin' exciting. You guys are resilient. You guys are tough, right? Doesn't mean you need to have a sword and a shield. It means the power of love resides within you. Okay. So love yourself. Be gentle with yourself. Nice talk to yourself, right? Not that negative, reaffirming that negative stuff, all right? So that's enough for now. I love all of you. Let it be done, and so it is done.